Hey everybody, welcome to another amazing WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas, and today I have a question coming in off of our YouTube channel comments, and we get so many every single week and month. It's incredible. But this one really kind of stood out to me, and I thought I can do a tutorial on that. So the question is, how do you make kind of a custom login screen? You know, if you've dealt with WordPress for long, you know that the opening login screen is kind of a little bit boring, and it lets everybody know right away, of course, that you're using WordPress, which is cool. Shout out to WordPress. But still, what if we can maybe put our logo there, or a message to our team there, or something kind of more customized, right? Maybe change the colors or something. Oh, we can do it. Check it out, y'all. I'm going to show you this pretty cool plugin that I found. And so far, it works really amazing. Of course, you want to be sure that it has active installs, and you want to be sure that it's tested up to the current version, sorry about that, that you're using. So you want to be sure of that. You also just want to be sure that the authors are keeping it real, right? They're keeping it updated. So check out all these cool customizations. This is one of the cool views of the login screen. You can actually put an image full screen if you wanted to. You can put a different logo up here. You can change all the colors. You can change the colors of this box. It goes pretty in depth as to what you can do here. So I'm going to show you something here as I log out. You can see this is our standard login logout screen, right? We're all familiar with that one. We're going to log in now, and you're going to go into your plugins and you're going to look for or do a search to install AG Customize Admin. Okay. And I've already done that. Of course, you went to add new and you did a search for it. Now, of course, this is not going to be accessible to those of you who are on the WordPress.com version. You have to be on the self-hosted version to add plugins. So just know that. If you don't have the functionality, one of two things is happening. Either you're not set to be an admin, so you don't have the privileges to add, or the permissions rather, to add a plugin, or you're probably on the free version of WordPress and you don't have the function already in there. If you're on the self-hosted, you're able to add, activate, and once it's activated, now this is tricky because you wouldn't really know where the customization lives. Check this out now. Now that it's installed and activated, underneath Tools, you're going to go to AG Custom Admin. Get ready to be mind blown here, y'all. There's so much customization. This is almost, if you've watched my YouTube channel, you know that there are things known as option overload, and here we are. But check this out. You can literally do anything you want to do to customize the whole user experience, not only on that login screen, but also inside the dashboard. So your admin bar, you can make changes to that. Your footer area of the website, if you wanted to change it from saying thank you for creating with WordPress, you could say created by the nerds at WebTegrity.com, right? You could put that there if you wanted to. Click Save Changes. Now, I want you to notice something kind of cool about this. There it is right there. Boom. How cool is that? I love it. I love it, love it. Fun changes like that. Dashboard, you can change all of these colors, and normally you can do that, but this takes you to the totally different next level. You can add a custom message. That's super cool. Here's our login screen that we were talking about. So how do we change that image header? This is what you do. You're going to upload a picture over to your media library, and I've already got one sitting here. Specifically for our viewer that asked me to make this video tutorial, they were asking, can I do something that maybe says employee login? You could just create a PNG image or just a regular image and put in there employee login right here. Upload that image to your library, and then you're going to go into this customization here and paste in that link to that image URL. And they've got really nice hover tooltips here. If you were to hover over, you can kind of read a little bit further into what this actually does. If somebody were to click on that image now, we want them to go to our home page, so you can put that in here. And I'm going to scroll down for now. That's all the customization I can do. You can certainly read through each one of these and see what else you'd want to do to that screen. But I'm going to go ahead and click Save Changes for now. And I'm going to log out so you can see what that looks like. Pretty cool, huh, y'all? There it is. So now we've got an image sitting in there, and I love it, love it. I'm going to show you one other thing that I think is pretty cool and an option for you to do, again, with this free version of this plugin. They have an area here. Again, we go to under the Tools section. They have an area here called Admin Menu. And what we want to do is adjust maybe something over here. Maybe we want to hide an area. Maybe we don't want people getting into the editor area underneath appearance because we're a little bit afraid of what they're up to. You could come down in here, open this up if you wanted to. Nope, lies. Hold on. There you go. Open this up. And if we wanted to hide that editor, just click hide that editor. We don't want anybody to see that area. Let's say on the post, maybe people don't understand that it's post. Maybe we want to just rename that as blog. I think that'd be kind of cool. Let's rename that. So those two changes have been made now, and obviously we don't see them taking effect yet. Let's scroll down here and click save changes. And we actually should probably not see them take effect just yet. I can still see this. Here's the reason why, and this is what's so cool about this. You can even set these customizations based on their user role. So I'm in here as an admin. So now I need to apply these changes even to the admin level people. So what we're gonna do now is say, yes, we wanna apply this to admin level and click save changes. So now this should change to blog. Excellent. And now when I go here, I cannot see the editor area. Pretty cool plugin for a totally free plugin. All right, I'm gonna put the link to this plugin in the description box below. And if you have questions about your WordPress website, will you please, first of all, take a moment to subscribe for free to our YouTube channel, because every Wednesday I'm producing a video just like this to help you improve your online experience. And if you have questions, please send them to us. I try to do my best to answer questions, not only in the comments area, but also via Twitter, over on our Facebook. We have people email us, we have people call us up. I wanna help you make a great experience with your WordPress website. So connect with me, let's get it done. Y'all have a great week. I'll see you next time. Bye, y'all.